Hi, this is Mike Wallach with TriMech, and I want to show you how to use display states instead of configurations for graphics-only differences in your models. So here I've got this part that's going to have four different versions. We're going to have an unpainted stainless steel version, and then we're going to have three painted versions. We have a red one, a blue one, and a gold one. And what I've done here is what many people would do, which is to create a different configuration for each of those variations. But really, the only change here is in the graphics. And configurations aren't really for graphical changes. That's what display states are for. Each one of these configurations has its own display state, and that's where that graphical data is being stored. So we don't really need all these configurations. So let's switch to a version of this file that is geometrically identical and still just has the one default configuration. So I'm going to create some new display states. I'm going to right-click on this existing display state and hit Add Display State from the context menu. And I can also right-click just in the panel itself and hit Add Display State. I'll do that a couple more times. Now let's rename these. We'll have red, blue, and gold. Now let's actually apply appearances to those. So I'll use the Appearances tab here on the task pane, and I'll grab that gold one and apply it to the part here, then switch to the blue display state, add that one, then to the red, and add that one. And now when I go back to the default, it's still just the unpainted stainless appearance. So we have one configuration and four different display states now. So what's the difference between doing it this way and doing it with four different configurations, each with its own display state? Well, let's take a look. Here I have the Windows File Explorer showing these two files. The pen holder with the display states, this one is shown on the bottom. And let me go ahead and save that. So it's 477 kilobytes. Well, the other one with configurations looks like it's not that much bigger, only 537. Let's switch back to that one. And since I opened this file, I've activated all of these configurations, and so they've all been rebuilt. But I haven't saved the file since all of that was done. So let's see what happens when I save it. That file size balloons to 1,659 kilobytes because each one of those configurations is adding its own set of body data to the file. So it's like having four different copies of this model in the one file. So file size increases dramatically, whereas the display states on the other version add almost nothing to the file size. Also, whenever you switch between one configuration and another, it automatically prompts a rebuild. But when you switch from one display state to another, there's no rebuild because it's just graphics data. So display states are much more efficient, especially with larger models and large assemblies. It can make a huge difference. I hope you found that interesting and useful, and have a good day.